Kelly Goldsmith, a 22-year-old behavioral research analyst from Rancho Santa Fe, California.
Yeah, has anyone had water today at all?
We didn't have canned goods. Yeah. Are you kidding me right now? We'd have no moisture.
He doesn't know how to use the can opener, does he?
You think?
Yeah. We'll see. We'll see when we get
there. I really hope he's not like that.
I think we're all worried about Jesse. Throwing up when you have so little hydration to go around is bad. It's bad for her, it's bad for us.
The hardest thing I would have to say is really, I'm unaccustomed to such physical drain. You know, I'm unaccustomed to having to work for my food, you know, work for my water. Very unaccustomed to it. And that's been hard.
You've all been affected by food not collected, so you're invited to our cafe. You might be elected as the next one ejected if you find yourself saying no way. It's a food one.
Oh, it's the gross food challenge.
That's all right. I like that.
Bring it on. All right.
I don't think if anyone is squeamish. You?
My one worry would be Jess, just because she doesn't feel well, but as long as she gets it down.
Yeah.
Tremel said that we have our disgusting food challenge today, and there's nothing I won't eat. You know, it could be beef brain, goat, testicles, whatever. Sounds good. Breakfast.
3, 2, 1, on your own.
Good job. All right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
We're on. Who you guys pick? Linda and Kelly for the tiebreaker. And it's a little bit bigger shot.
Yeah, cool.
In this challenge, first one that got to get this down your mouth. Now, are you guys happy that they're even?
Yeah.
We're happy.
Get them ready. Keep them down on the ground. 3, 2, 1, drink.
I just feel like a big loser, you know? I couldn't chug beer in college, and I can't chug blood out here. I just, you know, I tried my hardest. I wasn't grossed out by it. I didn't think it tasted bad. I thought for sure it was in the bag. You know, between Kim tripping in the last reward challenge and me failing to perform on my challenge today, it's, you know, it's anybody's game.
So, you know, absolutely, I'm scared and I'm vulnerable.
Kelly, last question. You're here tonight.
Because of me, I know. It's awful. I feel terrible. It sucks, too, because it wasn't something I was unprepared to do. It wasn't something I was incapable of. It was something I was excited for, and I couldn't be more bummed. I feel awful. It just sucks that it fell that way.
Okay.
Wow, Africa.
Go away!
He's good.
That sounded like maybe something that he got.
Hopperin is.
The lions are probably right over there sleeping in the grass watching us.
All you can do, victory is refreshing with clean water and shampoo.
So we gotta roll a stone.
Mm-hmm.
So rolling a stone?
It would just feel good to win something, and it'll feel good for our tribe. We've lost 2 people already.
Like
we got things, don't we?
You need something with bright colors. It's going to attract somebody.
One. We had something about the size of your thumb there that you could eat.
I mean, it's not as good as coconut. It's got a bad aftertaste.
If our team is just real losers and we lose everything, that's going to be awful.
Brought you back to this original drop point where it all began. For what, you guys could give me your buffs?
Oh my God.
Lex, Tom. Here's a map, Frank, to your new home.
Thank you, sir.
Kelly, here's a map to your new home. Samburo. Yo!
How many times did I say? I'm glad I'm not on that
Yeah,
team.
Well, now you are.
I'm gonna try to intervene and get as much gossip as I can.
Big ears, Kelly will get it.
We can use this as a good way to find out all sorts of information on their team. And it's really crucial for us to figure out which one of them has votes against them.
Is this a joke?
No.
Is this a joke?
No.
No.
Hey.
No, it's not for real.
No, it is.
Not for like good?
Yeah.
Where's
the merger?
It'll
it's
come.
On the way.
No way.
No way.
We've worked really hard and suffered a lot with no food and no water and stuff like that. And just to see people out here who just don't take it seriously and be stuck with them, it's painful. This is no Zamburu trap. I'm not on the Zamburu trap. The red is a red herring. It's a false front. I am still on Baran, and so is Lex, and so is Tom.
Hey, you guys didn't do 3 hours, did you?
I tried. I thought we were out there for at least 2 hours.
Don't get caught huddled up.
We have to anticipate going to Tribal Council because we are outmanned so drastically. If this challenge is in any way physical, I don't see the point in playing. We will lose. The good part about it is that me, Lex, and Tom have no votes against us.
Good morning.
How are you?
So, no matter who they pick, we should be okay as long as we pick the one of them that has votes against them. Tom and I and Lex have all sort of whispered our own little bit. They talk too loud, though, too. You gotta watch, because the eavesdropping, of course, goes both ways.
Whoa, bird sky.
But, we all like Brandon the best. Well, I mean, that's not true. I like Kim a lot, too. But Kim's just so much more of a physical threat. And then Lindsay, everyone thinks is really annoying.
That sucks. And that is terrible. I bet she just does not want to do it at all.
I think Lindsay's heart in the right place.
Oh, yeah. She's a sweet girl. She's just a big man.
People just want to see what's shaken up at Baran, because what goes on over there could totally affect what happens over here.
What do you think? Sure. Oh,
not some irritation.
I'm against him, and you would think it would come down 3-3.
You know why Silas has votes against him? Because Frank tried to get Silas in an alliance, and Silas said no.
Really?
So Frank went ballistic.
That's bizarre.
Yeah.
It ruled out Silas, because there's no way they would have known to vote.
Oh, yeah, that's exactly, yeah, that's sure what I mean.
What a little pig.
That makes sense. I can't believe I never thought of that, why Kim was doing this. It just hit me.
No, I didn't know she was doing this.
She did it, then the ghost.
Yes, all I saw her do was this.
She did that yesterday, too.
I'm such an idiot. All this time, Kim at the challenges, she was doing this. And I'm like, what does this mean, lose? Do you want me to throw the challenge? What's the L? The L? And then I'm sitting there, and I'm like, oh, Lindsay. Obviously, she thinks Lindsay has votes against her. And also, I think she was trying to tell me Brandon. Because she was doing something like this. I don't know. I think it's B in sign language. She knows sign language. I don't know it.
I think we need to go with the safest bet, as we've said all along.
We're playing hardball now.
Yeah, that's true.
He's like, I'm gonna make it through this, it's okay, da 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 da. So they've got this plan, and they sound like they've had it for like 2 or 3 days now.
We're not Zamburu anymore.
Right.
You know what I mean? So you guys are willing to relinquish Brandon?
Yeah. I mean, I just feel so bad, like, selling someone out, but everyone would look really positively at it.
Let me think about it.
Yeah, just think about it. We can talk after lunch.
I just thought, oh my God, if this can secure them not voting for me, I'll do it.
I wouldn't say they're just gone. Obviously, you know, we're very close with some of the people that were on Baran, and we still have loyalties to them, but it just really opened up our eyes that these people are great, and it's really changed up the game in a lot of ways. It's made everything a lot harder.
It just looks really good. We shouldn't have today, should we?
I hope so.
We may not.
This is the big Tom Buchanan spoon.
Lex is so politicking for a win, and that's fine, but just watching him make spoons for Tom and kiss ass to everybody and talk in his dad voice annoys me. Am I the only one who notices he's a totally weird person? It's annoying. I would like to vote off Lex in a perfect world. If I thought there was going to be no merger ever, then I would do it in a heartbeat. I love doing this. I do this at home.
So you like that little tingly sort of thing?
It's
starts
great.
Going numb?
You don't get this enough in life, I find.
Okay. All right. I'll see you guys in a little bit. Kelly, benches. You can sit and relax.
You see any buckets wavering at all?
None. The buckets are solid.
So how are things over there?
You know, they gave us a lot of information, like when you...
Obviously. I couldn't believe that.
No, I know. But I mean, we did by far the right thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, obviously. No. I'm glad he's gone. I'm ecstatic. I was so happy.
Yeah, I mean,
Frank seems kind of like a jackass, but the kids here really don't want Frank on the jury. Well, Frank hates women and doesn't want a woman to win, by the way, so I don't think we want him on the jury.
Okay.
Hey, you guys,
it's not even finished cooking yet. You're lucky.
Come on.
Hey, Big Tom.
Together, as you may have expected, you've got one more day till someone's ejected. Make a new flag, decide on a name, one that you'll keep for the rest of the game. Reach into the basket to give your spirits a lift with this housewarming gift. Frank is a very big loner. He socially seems so inept. I mean, I guess probably a large section of the population is introverted and antisocial, and that's fine, but I feel like there are prescription drugs to counteract that, and he should maybe be on them. We play this game, I Never, which is like, you're supposed to like tell dirty stories and whatever. Momo Magi? I don't know.
Together, creating a society.
Today, Lex came up with this scheme. Lex, the Grandmaster Lex, that for some reason people bow to. I don't understand why. Oh, and as if that's more ethical, because Lex is like, well, I can't boldface lie to him. Okay, you can just lie to him all day when it would be inconvenient to tell him the truth. But then the last possible moment, you'll slip in the truth, and that's going to make you an ethical person. Okay. I like Clarence. The kid has really grown on me. I mean, he sensed that people were getting rubbed the wrong way by him, and he changed his ways. I like him. I think he's friendly. I think he's funny. He's part of the group, unlike crazy outcast Frank.
Reality sets in. It's back.
That spent time looking.
Clarence in his war paint is just a testament to his selfishness. And that doesn't fly out here. He's a tribe's warrior. What? No. No, you're not. If I, like, started putting my socks in my boobs, you know, wouldn't you guys think I was weird?
Yeah, like it really mattered out here.
Right. He's always looking in the mirror. He's so vain. I was in a sorority, and I've never seen any girl as vain as Clarence. Whatever, though. Who am I to talk? It's his luxury item. Have fun. Paint yourself up like a little clown. That's fine.
That was real.
It's still real.
I know it's not me. It's not you. It's not Tom, for sure.
No.
It's not Ethan.
It's not Ethan.
The person that threw that vote at me.
And we'll cut the head off of whoever it is that did this, and whoever it is that has poisoned this.
This morning, Lex was just a total jerk. I mean, what do you expect in this game? I mean, I'm sorry. Someone voted against you, Mr. Ego. Deal with it.
It was not me.
I swear on your brother.
I swear on my brother. I swear on my brother's name. I swear on both my parents. I really would. I'll look you in the eye.
There you are.
I am. I promise you.
Okay, well, it really wasn't me, but screw you, Lex, if you're gonna sit here and yell at me like you're my dad, and I'm 5, and I just stole cookies for something I didn't do.
Amongst us, and I don't know who it is. That person.
Oh, one of these little weird music makers? Okay.
What is it?
This is like an African music making device.
All right.
Cool. Play with your thumb.
Okay.
And it says, coordination and persistence it'll take to win this one. You may run out of breath, but I guarantee you'll have some fun. You best use all your leverage, focus, you don't want to miss, because you haven't seen a reward quite as cool as this.
Come on, Kelly.
I keep breaking my plank.
Woo! Kelly, welcome to the game. Oh.
Here. Hey, this is what I gathered. T told me that you're correct. Lex does think you voted for him. I refuse to spend my time here kissing up to him, trying to convince him I didn't vote against him.
He might not be around.
I've tried to work a little bit on Kelly. I don't want to push her too hard, so I'm waiting to see what happens to immunity challenge.
I'm not going to say that would make me sad, but after what happened last time, I'm kind of gun-shy about Kim. She kind of asked me to vote with them, and I said no, I have to vote with my tribe, but, you know, best of luck with your little coup, and we'll see what happens.
And you sure Frank's on with that? He's...
Yeah, Frank's definitely in on this. Kelly said she wasn't going to vote.
You That's see the plan?
Thinking with your head. Everything lays on the next immunity challenge. I mean, if Lex wins it...
Still alive? See what you got, Kelly? Nope, wasn't a rock.
I know what it was. Ever since the immunity challenge, things have been very different. Different than they've ever been before. Lex hasn't been laying down the orders of who I'm supposed to vote for, who we're supposed to vote for, so I have no clue really what's going on.
You don't know what's going on.
Well, yeah.
Well, we've hit an impasse.
I can tell.
I made a commitment to myself to try to, that by the time the third day came, I was gonna try to snip out the rat and whoever that was, that's who would get my vote. Now, if that means that we're splintering at this point, so be it. But I, you know, it doesn't seem that alliances are what they used to be.
I don't know, I thought, you know, I mean, whatever, if that's what, if everyone's made up their mind, then that's fine. And the whole thing about the vote against you wasn't me. So right. If that would be anyone's reason to vote against me, I would really hope there was more to it than that.
It's gonna be what it's gonna be. So.
All right.
Okay.
My butt is on the line because, you know, my own teammates are all trying to turn against me, and I'm just like, this is ridiculous. I feel like my only real strategy is to try to defect and team up with the four from Samburu.
Okay, okay. Oh, I'm fine. I don't even know what's going on. They're just like, we don't want to have an alliance anymore. Everyone wants to vote for different people.
Okay, then we can all vote our own way.
That's fine, and I'll vote, I mean.
And I'll vote for Lex.
I'll vote for Lex, too.
You have my word. I'll vote for Lex.
I'll vote for
me. If I change for any reason, I will come and let you know. But I'll try to work on T-Bird. All right, I'll let you.
You don't trust your long term, do you?
Yes.
Al told me this morning they're wanting me to vote Kelly off tonight.
When it's me, you'll know it. I couldn't be more excited to be casting this vote. I never wanted you to win, and now I hope you won't. If this is the last vote I cast, then at least I got a vote for you, who I've always found to be not fun to be around.
Kelly, you need to bring me your torch.
All right. Look it up.
Kelly, the tribe has spoken. Time for you to go.
Hi. I don't know if I'm supposed to talk louder. I don't know. Anyways, yeah, so I'm done with Survivor, and that's exciting. I think that in all reality, I can't help but be myself. And I've never been too good at sticking to one click. I always kind of float around. So it was hard for me not to have friends in different places, and that kind of screwed me. But, you know, hey, I made it past the hard part with the boulders and whatnot, and for a skinny girl, that's kind of, you know, it's a big deal. Actually, I love you, Mom, Dad, and Brian, and Rush Kappa, everyone. I love all you girls too. I love all my friends. Thank you, everyone who made me who I am. I had a lot of fun. I hope it was fun to watch. Okay, I'm done.
And I've seen my name on more than one or two cards at previous tribal councils, so I know what it's like to almost be taking that walk of shame. But that's the reality of tribal council, and
I gotta call attention to something I just noticed when the jury walked in, which is the shirt that Kelly's wearing, Shameless, which I can only imagine is referring back to last tribal council when the whole notion of the walk of shame came up. Which survivor listed manipulating men on their application as one of their favorite hobbies? Which survivor listed manipulating men on their application as one of their favorite hobbies? Everybody reveal. Kim says Kelly. Ethan says Kelly. Lex says Kelly. Big Tom says Kelly. Everybody's right. Next question.
I can't help but be myself. It was hard for me not to have friends in different places, and that kind of screwed me. But hey, I made it past the hard part with the boulders and whatnot, and for a skinny girl, you know, it's a big deal.
I don't know what approach I'm going to take tonight. I would like to see them squirm. I'm the sorest loser out there, and I'll be the first one to admit it. So after the Kelly voted off debacle, which it was, because I didn't vote for stupid Lex, but that's fine, I can't wait. I hope I get in there, and they're quaking in their little Reeboks. I just want to see fireworks, because I've been sitting there for a really long time, and I just like to watch things happen. I want to go now! Hi, guys. I'm going to say hi. I haven't talked to you in a while. I've had 15 days to sit here and think about who was going to be across from me on this big night. And to be totally honest, I had hoped to see you guys on this side of things with me. But it could have been worse. Kim. I was surprised
and disappointed by your conduct my last few days at camp, but you did do some great things too. You gave me something that I've been wanting for a while now, and that was giving Lex the chance to do his own walk of shame. So thank you for that. Though you totally sold me out, I admire you for everything you've done, but I hope you know that part of your success tonight comes at my expense. If you think you did this with high integrity, don't flatter yourself. On the other hand, we have Ethan. You know, I've had to sit there for a long time and I've listened to what Jeff said, and this game's about relationships, and I certainly didn't see you try to make one with me. I don't know about everybody else. Hence my dilemma. I thought a lot about it. Gonna need a little help. Guy's gotta pick a number between 1 and 1,000.
Kim.
3.
Ethan. 888.
Thank you. Very proud of you both.
Benjamin, isn't there something you wanted to tell me? Oh, yes, Mrs. Robinson. Thank you very much for the opportunity. No, no, Benjamin. The room number. 568. Graduate was my favorite movie. Congratulations.